Happy Thursday, everybody. We are here today at Amazing Animals Incorporated, and we got some very special stuff for you guys.
I can't wait. Like, when we woke up this morning and Tim was like, we're gonna do this thing today, I was like thinking, oh, okay, it'll be cool. But then we showed up and it's so cool. So I'm excited for you guys to see this video.
So let's see what it's all about. This is Brian. He's the owner of Amazing Animals, and he's got some exciting stuff in store for us. So can you tell us a little bit about what Amazing Animals is?
Yeah, Amazing Animals is a nonprofit exotic animal rescue. We're here in St. Cloud, Florida, so right outside of Orlando. We have 2.5 acre facility. We started it, gosh, 8 years ago now. We rescue everything besides cats and dogs. So exotic animal means anything that's not a cat or a dog, we will rescue it. We are gonna take you on a tour of our property and see all the animals, and let's start in the reptile house. Sound good?
Yeah. Now real quick, you said you're taking us on a tour, but this place isn't open to the public.
No, exactly. What we do is we do $25 donation per person, and we take you on a private tour. So it's just you and your group, whoever you want to bring with. We ask that there's a minimum of 2 people, and we take you on a tour of the whole facility, just you. We are not open to the public. We live here. That's our house right there. So the backyard is our sanctuary, and we do a lot of road shows. So we'll go to a birthday party, we'll go to a nursing home, we'll go to school. We bring the animals to you, but sometimes people want to come out here and see all of the animals, because we can only bring 7 or 8 animals out, but you can see over 100 of them here at the sanctuary.
Now, Jen, are you concerned about this sign right here?
I'm excited to see what's inside.
This is my friend Tripod.
Tripod is a little three-legged bearded dragon. And bearded dragons make great pets. They're really easy to take care of. Very popular pet. We believe it or not, we get a lot of them in, even though they make good pets. And they are from Australia. They love to eat crickets and mealworms and lettuce. Eats lots of lettuce. This is my buddy Azul. Azul is a blue tongue skink, also from Australia. So I'm keeping you in one continent here in Australia.
What gives them the blue tongue? What is that?
So it's a way to ward off predators. Usually in wild, anything that's really colorful is like, hey, I'm scary, leave me alone.
Okay.
But it's also a way that he can see. He actually takes particles of the air, and most snakes and lizards, a lot of them can actually taste particles of the air and get a mental picture of what they're looking at. Now we're gonna go to Africa, something a little bit bigger. This is our savanna monitor. We get in a bunch of these guys. A lot of people get them as pets. This is baby, because we got him in as a baby. He was emaciated, he was tiny, skin and bones. And now he looks pretty much like a normal savanna monitor should look. Wow. He's about 4 years old.
And what's their average like lifespan?
These guys can live almost 20 years, 15 to 20 years in captivity, not as long in the wild. Saw some lizards. Now we're gonna get to some slithery friends, some of my snakes. We're gonna start off small. And in my world, this is small.
This is small.
Wow.
So this is a ball python from Africa. This is a morph. So it has a vanilla gene, a pastel gene, and a cinnamon gene. They're coming out with thousands of different color mutations of the same animal. And some of them can be $100. A normal ball python, you may pay 50, 60 bucks. I've seen ball pythons at reptile shows go for $100,000.
Wow. And how old is this one?
This one's about 10 years old.
Really?
Yep.
Holy cow.
Full grown. This is as big as they get. So when moms ask us what makes a good pet, we always tell them the ball python.
Okay.
Do you
stay small? Animals that stay small are generally easier to take care of. They have a smaller enclosure. They have smaller requirements. And a snake like Monty here, he only has, that's Monty Python, by the way. They only have to eat once a week. So what else do they only do once a week? Only poop once a week.
Oh my gosh, you can finally live your Britney Spears dream out.
Oh yeah.
You can have her just like Britney.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
She weighs about 20 pounds. And these are the snakes that are in the Everglades. This is an albino Burmese python.
But not naturally.
So naturally, no. These guys are an invasive species. Hurricane Andrew in early mid-1990s. Came through Miami and took out a facility full of big snakes.
Oh, is that why they're out down there?
That's why they're down there.
I always wondered.
There's no natural predators, and these guys are eating everything from our native birds, raccoons, deer, even alligators. So,
wow.
A big female like this can be about 20 feet, and a big male can get a little bit shorter, about 18.
She weighs a lot.
Yeah, she looks heavy.
So we got Thelma and Louise here from the Florida Fish and Wildlife. Someone had them illegally. We have a special permit and a license to have them. And they were both confiscated and brought to us because a gentleman had them that was not licensed and he got caught. There you go.
Oh my gosh. Wow.
So he was also confiscated. One of our Florida Fish and Wildlife officers brought him to us. Someone had him. He's an American alligator.
Oh, somebody had him as a pet?
Yeah, wow. That's very illegal.
Yeah.
We have another special permit that allows us to have crocodilians. So unfortunately, alligators get a really bad rap. There's over a million of them here in Florida, but in the 70s, there was only a couple of hundred. And the government came in and protected them, and that's why it's illegal to trap an alligator or hunt them without a special permit. And now they do hunt them now because there are so many of them and their numbers are so great. And these are an apex predator, and they're really important to have in the environment because they really control population of a lot of animals, and they also provide a food source for a lot of animals. A mother alligator can have up to 80 babies, and only about two of those will survive. Average clutches are more like 40, 50 eggs, but only about two of those will be an adult alligator. The rest of them are food for raccoons, fish, snakes, lizards, turtles, all sorts of other animals will eat them. There's only really a couple reasons why you'd get bit by an alligator here in Florida. In the springtime, right about now, the only thing that a big male alligator wants in his territory is a bunch of females. If you get too close to an alligator, you could become food. And then the last reason why an alligator would bite or attack a human is because people feed wild animals. You're training those alligators to come right up to you. All you're doing is telling that animal that food comes from humans. These guys learn pretty quickly. If I just walk up to a human, they should give me food. Mm. Well, if that human doesn't have food, them and their dog can become food. So don't feed wild animals.
So this is our buddy Bam Bam, and Bam Bam had a really funny story. The person who bought him, I'm just gonna hand him to you, hold him like a baby.
Hold him like a baby.
Oh,
there you go.
Oh my gosh.
They're very soft. Just don't put fingers in his face. Anything in Bam Bam's face is Bam Bam's food.
Oh no.
The people who had him thought they could just leave him in the house like a house cat. And he found very soon that the bed and the couch was very comfy to burrow in. As you can see, these great big claws, they're burrowing species. And he burrowed in the lady's couch and her bed. And all the stuffing was out of the bed and the couch, and Bam Bam was snuggled inside. Needless to say, the lady did not want Bam Bam anymore, and that's how we have Bam Bam. And he goes to schools with us. He was purchased in a pet store, so his skunker has been removed. He has no smell, no skunker left. And veterinarians do that like a surgery, like you spay and neuter a cat or a dog. But yeah, we don't recommend him as a pet for everybody. Not everything in a pet store makes a good pet for everybody.
So another cool thing about Amazing Animals Inc. is that they do have the signs on each of the enclosures as well. So you're getting all of this great information, which is really awesome.
So this is Thor, he's our marble fox. And he's a little shy, and he likes to take an egg and just run and hide it. And he was someone's pet, and he got a little too big for them. But a lot of people think he's an Arctic fox because he's all white, but marbled is just a color variation of the red fox.
So why does he hide eggs?
That's what they do, actually. They will hoard a bunch of food and poop and pee on it.
Oh.
And say, this is mine, don't anyone touch it. That's like they mark their territory. So he gets a really high-grade dog food. He gets mice, he gets chicken legs, and he gets eggs. We'll fill up his little dish of dog food, and he'll pee and poop in it and eat it slowly. That's like a fox thing to do.
So he would not make a good pet.
No. They have a musk. Can you smell that a little bit of?
Yeah.
it's pretty clean in here, and he still has that musk.
These are our Joffrey cats from South America. These guys are a small cat that lives in the rainforest. And as you can see, they have a beautiful pelt. And they are actually hunted for their pelts in their native land. They're hunted for meat. And they're suffering a lot from habitat loss, because the rainforest is being destroyed at a very alarming rate. These guys only get about 10 or 12 pounds, so they're a smaller species of cat, so it's great for us to work with here at Amazing Animals. So you have Rio on you, he's the male. He's about 9 months, and this is Aries, she's the female, and she's about 6 months. So they purr, like big tigers and stuff, they don't purr, so these guys do purr.
Wow.
So excited.
They're
coming
so
for you.
Excited.
Butt in the face, just like a regular cat.
She's even almost kind of making like puppy sounds.
Uh-huh.
Wow.
They get excited. This is he.
Oh, he. Yeah, sorry. Sorry.
He's bigger. She is golden, more golden.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
It's really hands-on.
Yeah.
And that's what kind of sets us apart, is that hands-on element. And we hope that you're going to go home and love these animals and want to help protect them and
figure out ways that you can help. And for these guys, the greatest thing to do, just being a smart consumer. A lot of things you buy at grocery stores are actually made from cutting down trees in rainforests. Palm oil is really bad. A lot of the cocoa plants, so a lot of the chocolate companies, oranges, they're cutting down rainforests and putting up orange groves. So look on the back of your orange juice and see where your oranges are from. Try to get Florida orange juice that was made here in Florida, and you're helping not contribute to people cutting down rainforests. Those are some of the easiest ways.
Where are you gonna go? You're just gonna put your butt in my face?
Diamondback terrapins are really cool. They live where the freshwater and the saltwater meets, in mangroves and marshes, and they have a really cool tear duct that they will cry out the salt, secrete the salt out of their eyes.
Oh.
And that's why, because if we drink salt water, we get dehydrated, and that's how they deal with the salt water. This is Tank. He was walking down Curry Ford Road in Orlando.
Oh my gosh.
Walking down the sidewalk. Police officer stopped and picked him up, and he got here, and no one claimed him, so we have him. So these are a sulcata tortoise. They're from Africa, and they are the third largest tortoise species in the world. And that little guy right there is a red-footed tortoise from South America.
What's he gonna do?
He's just gonna look at your shoes and think, oh, it's white, I can eat that. The little red foot here, that's full grown. 7-8 inches. That's as big as they're ever gonna get. These tortoises still have a long way to go. It'll be about almost three times the size of this bigger one. So we get in lots of parrots. We have some blue and gold macaws, a little sun conure, a double yellow-headed Amazon, and a lilac-crowned Amazon in here right now. Sky. Sky's blushing. She likes to be on camera. Right, Sky? Yeah?
She was totally nodding.
You can say, I love you. You're just gonna pretend to say it while I say it? This is Archie. Archie is our barred owl. Barred because he has bars on his feathers. And he's a native Florida raptor, bird of prey. We have a very special permit for him. He doesn't have his left eye. It's totally not there. He was knocked out of his nest and something got his eye, and there's no depth perception, so he wouldn't be able to hunt on his own. And we use him for educational programs. He goes out and does lots of educational programs with us. And if you ever find a raptor, it's really important not to mess with them and try to help them. Get them, scoop them up into a box, put a towel over them, and bring them to a licensed rehabber like the Audubon right away. Because unfortunately, a lot of people imprint on the bird, and that's what has happened to this guy over here. This is Beetle. He's our red-shouldered hawk. Also, we got him from the Audubon, and someone tried to help him out for a couple of weeks before they brought him to the rehabber, and he looks at people as mom and dad. So he'll never be able to be released because of that. And he also goes out and does off-site programs with us. So now we're going into our bobcat enclosure. And this is Willow. She is a Florida bobcat. Same thing, she was imprinted. Someone tried to help her for a little too long that wasn't licensed and not doing it properly, and she has no wild instinct. She's not a nice cat. We don't pet her and let her run on us like we do the Joffreys, because we hand raise them. But as you can see, a wild bobcat would be running, trying to get away from us and screaming at us. She's just hanging out. This is our barnyard friends. This is Pixie, the white goat. This is Carlton. These are dwarf goats, mini goats from Africa. And in that sweetness, she's a miniature potbelly pig. Now, a lot of people get mini potbelly pigs and think they're gonna be those little micro mini teacup things. They pay a lot of money for a baby pig and think it's only gonna get 10 pounds. And then they turn into Sweetness here, who's about 50 pounds.
Hello.
She loves her butt scratched. Oh, the butt scratch. So this is our alligator snapping turtle. He's a big dude.
Oh my goodness. Wow.
These guys are one of the larger species of turtles in the world. Turtle lives in the water, tortoise lives on land. He's about 50 pounds. They actually, they're an ambush predator. So they'll wedge themselves back somewhere and just sit. And what they do is they stick their tongue out and open their mouth, and a fish will swim right in their mouth thinking it's a worm, and they just smash it in half and eat it.
So the last enclosure that we're going into, which is the one I'm most excited about. Look. I can't wait.
This is Luke, a two-toed sloth from South America. You can hold that in front of him and feel free to pet him nice and gently on his back. But as you can see on his forelimbs, on the front ones, he has two toes. That's how you know he's a two-toed sloth. All sloths have three toes on the hind limbs. He has little tiny pupils that goes to show he doesn't have the greatest vision. And you can see how those claws work there. Those claws are mainly for climbing and hanging, but they do swat at things when they feel threatened. So you can see him holding his food and you can give him a little pet there. And these guys are suffering a lot in the rainforest because of deforestation. So just like we were talking about with the Joffrey cats, the best way to help these guys out in the wild is be a smart shopper. Purchase things that are rainforest safe. Not a lot of people have ever seen this. They have really big ears. They're mammals, just like you and I. You see that ear?
Oh, wow.
They have great hearing.
That's so, it's very interesting.
And they have very coarse fur. When you touch them, it's very coarse. Moss and algae actually grow on them. So they're a living ecosystem within themselves. And some animals in the rainforest solely live. Some insects, I should say, solely live on a sloth. So if we lose a sloth, we'll lose those insects as well.
Wow.
So it's pretty crazy to think about. He loves his apple. So he doesn't get very much apple because, again, the sweet stuff isn't the greatest for him, just like you and I. But that's one of his favorite, apple and mango. And you see how sharp it looks like those teeth are?
Yeah.
They actually don't have any enamel on their teeth. Oh. It looks like he has fangs or canines. They actually are born with all molars, but without the enamel, they grind down to be that sharp, sharp, sharp looking vampire teeth that you see there. Those are just molars.
And do they do any kind of like marking or spraying or anything?
Yeah, do you see the black on the branch above you?
Oh, yeah.
That's his butt. And so is this right here.
Oh, okay.
And so we don't, we clean it, but not very often because it's like, he'll just redo it.
Well, it's like you want it to have a scent, right?
To have his home feel, okay. Yep. This is all him.
Funny. Man. Oh, I love him so much.
This is a kinkajou? Kinkajou?
Yeah, the kinkajous live next door to the sloths. We have three boys in here, and we got them all because people get them when they're little babies and they're easy to manage. When they get a little bigger and hit sexual maturity, they turn into a very different animal than what you raised.
So he's very angry all the time, so we're not going in there with him.
And do they do any kind of like spraying or anything?
Not really, they pee. They just pee a lot.
So that's it from Amazing Animals. We want to thank Brian for having us out, and you have Facebook, Twitter, Instagram?
Yeah, we are on Facebook, we have Instagram, and our website. So please check us out, like us, follow us. We do a lot of events and a lot of fundraising, and we share a lot of new photos of animals coming in. And if you like it, please go to our website and contact us and book a tour to come out. Again, it's a $25 donation per person, and you get to do pretty much everything we did. You get to go in the sanctuary and see all the animals and get in all the enclosures and get up close personal with lots of animals from all over the world.
Yeah, and we're going to put links to all that stuff down below in the description, so make sure you check it out.
Thank you, Tim.
You're welcome, Brian. Thanks for having us out, and we will see you guys tomorrow. And now it's time to pay the price.